Now let us talk about more about cylindrical coordinates and how we can convert them into Cartesian coordinates and vice versa. So in the previous lecture we basically discussed about cylindrical coordinates and its different coordinates, which were rho, phi and z. So rho was basically the radial distance from this z axis to the circumference of this cylinder, and phi was this angle, and z was the height in the z direction, right? So one thing we did not discuss in the previous lecture was that how these three coordinates, which is rho, phi and z, are perpendicular to each other, because I already told you that these coordinates are orthogonal coordinates. So all the three unit vectors in these coordinate direction must be perpendicular to each other. So what happens, can you tell me the direction of rho if I start from this point? Let me change the color of the pen. If I start from this point and go radially outward, this a rho, the unit vector in the direction of rho, should be outward, towards the outside of this circle, right? And this angle must be perpendicular. Like if you draw a tangent on this particular point P, the tangent will be like this now. So this arrow vector or radial vector must be at 90 degree from this tangent vector. So this arrow is the unit vector of this circular cylindrical coordinate system, which goes outward. And why am I calling it a circular cylindrical? Because the cylinder is circular in nature. If you cut the cylinder, you will see from outside that it is a perfect circle, right? So here in this diagram, we are just seeing a part of that circle. If you complete this circle, the whole cylinder will be completed like this, right? So coming back to the topic, the first unit vector in the direction of rho was going outward from this circle. And the second unit vector, which is represented by A phi, this one, will be in the direction of where the angle is moving, where the angle phi is moving. So if you see, this angle phi is moving in this direction. So at this point, or rather, if you take on this P point, you see that the angle is going in this direction, right? Here, angle is going in this direction, your phi angle. So we are, since we are talking about all these unit vector at this point P, this direction of this unit vector phi or A phi must be in the direction of this tangent at this point P, right? Because this angle is moving in this direction, and exactly at this point P, the unit vector's direction must be in the direction of the tangent. When and what is a tangent? For any circle at any point, suppose this point is P, the tangent is something that just touches this point. So this was the direction of x as shown here, and this was point P. This was our angle phi. So the direction of this tangent here will be representing the direction of the unit vector A phi, right? So since we already knew that this arrow direction, this unit vector arrow, was perpendicular to this tangent, so this will be the reason why this A phi unit vector will be perpendicular to arrow. And now you already know that z is obviously in the upper direction, which is perpendicular to both the A phi and arrow. So now we have proved that all the three unit vectors, which are AZ, arrow and A phi, are perpendicular to each other. So this is why we call it a orthogonal coordinate system. Now, for any orthogonal coordinate system, if you are representing a vector using these three orthogonal coordinates, then you will get that the magnitude of this vector will always be the under root of square of each individual elements, sum of the square of each individual element. So this formula will hold true for all kind of orthogonal systems, right? So you must have studied this formula in Cartesian coordinate. Let me show you in the next slide. You must have studied in Cartesian coordinate that suppose this is x, this is y, and this is z. So if some line is in xy plane, right? If some line is in XY plane like this, and let me call this, the length of this line as R, then what will be the length of this R line will be? Suppose this is X and this is Y, then R will be under root X square plus Y square. You already know this. Now, what happens if this line R is in 3D? I mean, it is like here, and this point P is here, whose value is X, Y, Z. Then definitely the value of R will be X square plus Y square plus Z square. And what is R? R is the magnitude of this vector A, right? So similarly, in the cylindrical coordinate system also, if the three coordinates, here it is X, Y, Z, in cylindrical coordinate, it is rho, phi, and Z. So whatever coordinate you take, if they are perpendicular to each other, this formula is going to be the same. So in cylindrical case, this R formula will be, it will be, suppose in the, if the vector is a rho, here small a rho is the unit vector obviously, plus a phi, plus a z, then the magnitude of A, which is R, will be equal to a rho square plus a phi square plus a z square, right? So this is what I told in the previous slide. Now, since this phi is an angle which can be represented either in degrees or in radians, like I think you must be knowing what is the difference between degrees and radian. And if not, you should revise the mathematics. Since this phi is in degree, it is an angle, a question might be arising in your mind that this a phi value is also having a unit in degrees or radian, and which means this is also representing angle. But this is not the case. Actually, a phi depends on the quantity which is being represented by this unit vector. For example, if there is a force of 10 newton which is acting on a particle in circular motion. Suppose some particle is going in a circular motion, and the force is also acting circularly in this circular motion direction, and it is having a value of 10 newton. And if I represent this force as 10 a phi, and since this is in newton, then automatically this unit vector will hold the unit as newton, because this 10 is a constant, it cannot itself has any unit. So this unit vector a phi depends on the quantity, and it does not have the unit as a degree, right? Now since these three unit vectors, which are a rho, a phi, and a z, are orthogonal, which means they are perpendicular to each other, then obviously their dot product will be one. And I hope you know what is dot product from your mathematics class. So if two vectors A and vectors B are having a dot product, you will get magnitude of A into magnitude of B into cos theta. Theta is the angle between these two vectors, right? So this is dot product. So since a rho and a phi are unit vectors in the direction of rho and phi, and similarly a z is also a unit vector in the direction of z, the magnitude of these unit vectors is 1, and direction is towards rho or phi or z. So dot product of two same vectors is always going to be 1, because the direction is same. So phi angle will be 0, so cos phi will be 1. Similarly, the dot product between two different orthogonal vectors is going to be 0, because since phi is 90 degree, cos phi is always 0, right? So this is what it is written. And what about the cross product? If two vectors, one is rho, one is phi, and other one is z, so phi is 90 degree with rho, and these both phi and rho are at 90 degree with z. So using the thumb rule, if you take cross product of this is a rho, this is a phi, and this is a z, right? So if you take the cross product between a rho and a phi, what you are going to get? Z. You must be knowing what how the cross products work. So if the two vectors are perpendicular to each other, then if we take cross product between them, then we will get another vector which is 90 degree at both of them. So, and it goes in a particular direction. So using the right thumb rule. So the dot cross product between arrow and FI is going to give you AZ, which is what it is written here. Similarly, a cross product between FI and AZ is going to give you arrow. And similarly, a cross product between AZ and arrow is going to give you FI. Now, coming to the transformations between cylindrical and Cartesian. As you can see, I have used both the coordinates, the X, Y, Z coordinate or the Cartesian coordinate. And I have written the values of a cylindrical coordinates also. So this P point can be represented both in X, Y, Z and rho, phi, Z. So if you see in this figure, this X and Y, if I make a plane of this X and Y, and this this P point is projected in this X and Y plane, so it will fall at somewhere here. I think I discussed something like this in the previous class, in the previous video also. So as similar to, if you connect this line here, this line will be showing in the direction of A rho, right? This is rho. Similarly, if you go just Z height down in the XY plane, the similar thing, you can say that this is the direction of A rho, right? This is your A rho direction. And this length is rho. And this angle is phi. So if the projection of this point in the X line having a length of X and a projection of this line in the Y axis having a length of Y, then can you tell me if we can represent the value of rho in terms of X and Y? Definitely, you must have studied in the trigonometry that this rho can be projected on X and the value will be X is equal to rho cos phi, right? If you take a projection of this rho in x-axis, it will give a value of rho cos phi. Similarly, y will be given as rho sine phi because this is phi. So this will be 90 minus phi. So this will give you a rho sine phi. So this is what it is written. And since z is same in both the coordinate systems, so z is going to be same. In the vice versa, since you can see this is a right angle triangle. And this length is x. This length is y and this is rho. So from the right angle triangle, you already know that rho is equal to under root x square plus y square. And what about this angle? Phi, phi is given by length divided by base, tan inverse of y by x. So it will be given as tan inverse y upon x. And since z is same, z is going to be the same in both the axes. So this is what it is written. So if a point is given in Cartesian or in cylindrical coordinate, you can convert it into the other coordinate, either Cartesian or cylindrical, using these two formulas. Now, similar to the conversion of points values between Cartesian and cylindrical, we can also convert the unit vectors. For Cartesian system, it is AX, AY, AZ, and for cylindrical, it is arrow, FI, and AZ. So, let us first draw all these unit vectors here. So you can see that this direction is arrow. And we already discussed in the previous slide that this tangent direction is represented by FI. So if this is the FI direction, the opposite direction will be represented by minus FI, right? So I'm writing it minus FI because it is going to be convenient for our analysis. Can you tell me that this is X direction? Which means this also represents the direction of AX, unit vector towards AX. So I'm just going to tell you one and others will be automatically understandable for you. So this is the direction of AX. And if I draw a parallel line here, let me change the color. This is the direction of AX, right? And this was the direction of your arrow and this was the direction of minus FI, right? This is phi angle. This is 90 degree. So this angle is going to be 90 minus phi. And since this is a tangent, this whole angle is 90 degree. So this angle is going to be again phi, right? This angle is going to be phi. Again, this since this whole angle is 90 degree, so since this arrow direction and this AX direction had an angle of phi, so this angle is also going to be phi, right? Now, I am going to draw this whole area here in a little bit of large, right? So this direction is going to be your arrow. Let me draw this in red so that you don't confuse. This direction was minus a phi, right? There was a dotted line, this line. This line was basically represented y-axis, right? And this line was basically representing x-axis. So let me change the color again. This direction I showed you was AX, right? Since this angle was phi, then definitely this angle will be how much? 90 minus phi. So this angle was 90 minus phi. And how much was this angle? Definitely phi. Because this angle was phi, so this angle will be automatically phi. So can you tell me that which proportions of cylindrical coordinates or which cylindrical coordinates are going to contribute towards the direction of AX? Obviously A phi and A rho, because AZ is perpendicular to all of them. So projection of AZ at 90 degrees is going to be zero. So can you tell me from this diagram that what will be the value of AX? So you can directly write AX is equal to how much A rho will have a projection here on AX. So it will have A rho cos phi. So you can write A rho cos phi plus this A phi minus A phi, sorry, will have a projection here like this. So it will also add in AX. So we can say that minus A phi, and this angle is 90 minus phi. So I will write it cos 90 minus phi. So cos 90 minus phi is sine phi, right? So you can write it as A rho. Sorry, cos phi minus a phi sine phi. So this way you can get the value of unit vector AX using the unit vectors of cylindrical coordinates a rho and a phi. So this is what it is written here in the first equation. AX is a rho cos phi minus a phi sine phi, right? Similarly, you can calculate other quantities also. You just do the trigonometry and you can find the values of AY and AZ is going to be same. And in the vice versa, you will have to do the same thing. So A rho will be obviously, let me clear the diagram. So for this one, I'm just going to tell you one and you will understand the other one. So A rho is definitely is in the direction of rho. So this is your A rho. And this is contributed by X. So if you take the projection of X on this axis, how much it will be? It will be AX cos phi. Definitely this is the phi angle, right? So A rho is equal to AX cos phi. And again, you will have a projection of Y also, because Y is also going to contribute to this A rho. So you can write plus AY. And what is this angle? Since this is phi, this is going to be 90 minus phi. So it will be AY cos 90 minus phi. And what is cos 90 minus phi? It is sine phi. So you will get AX cos phi plus AY sine phi, right? So this is what it is written here. AX cos phi plus AY sine phi. So similarly, you can get the values of A phi and AZ is going to be the same. So this equation number one, we are going to use in the next part. Now what we have done till now is we have converted the points from Cartesian to cylindrical and vice versa. And then we have converted the unit vectors also. And now we are going to convert the whole vector. So suppose we are having a vector in Cartesian coordinate like this, AX, AX plus AY, AY plus AZ, AZ. Using the previous formula, like for ax, ay, and az, which are unit vectors here. You see, you can put the values of ax as this, ay as this, and az here. So if you put these values, what you will get? You will get ax into cos phi a rho minus sin phi a phi plus in the place of ay, small ay, you can similarly put this value ay, and similarly you can put other in the last value az, right? So this value is filled by this part. So I'm not writing it. So what we have done is I have expanded it and written it like this. So I have taken the a rho different and then a phi different and then az different. So from here, from this equation, you can say that the value of a rho is this, a phi is this, and az is this. So you already know what is the value of ax, you already know what is the value of ay, and you will already know what is the value of az, because the vector is already given in the Cartesian coordinate. So using just this formula, this unit vector changing formula, you can directly convert that vector from Cartesian to cylindrical and vice versa. So if we represent this particular, these three equations in the matrix form, it will take this form, like this. So this will give, this formula will directly give you the conversion of this a rho, ax, ay, az value directly to the a rho, a phi, and az values. And if you take the inverse of this matrix, you will just get the vice versa. So you will not be able to calculate ax, ay, az from the values given in the form of a rho, a phi, and az. If you look closely, these values which are here are nothing but the dot products of unit vectors in the Cartesian and in the cylindrical coordinates. So in the first row, if you are calculating ax, ay, and az, the first row will be the dot product of unit vector ax with a rho, a phi, and az. Similarly, in the second row, it will be unit vector ay with a rho, a phi, and az. And in the last, it will be az dot producted with a rho, a phi, and az. So using this formula, you can directly convert a given vector from Cartesian to cylindrical and vice versa. So I think you don't need to remember this formula, because in the question, it will be very easy for you to convert them. We are just going to discuss one example later. So let us take this example. It is given that there is a point in the Cartesian coordinate which is having a value of minus 2, 6, and 3. And a vector is also given. A is equal to y ax plus x plus z ay, and there is no component in the z direction. And now we have to express this point P and this vector A in cylindrical coordinate. And also we have to evaluate the A value at this P point in both Cartesian and cylindrical systems. So what we have x value as minus 2, y as 6, and z as 3, right? So if we put these values here in this a vector, we will get how much? A is equal to 6ax plus, this is minus 2 plus 3 will become 1. So we will get 1ay. And obviously, we don't have any z component, so it will be 0 into az. So this is our point whose values is minus 2, 6, 3, and the vector A is now represented using Cartesian coordinates. Now, first of all, we will be converting this point into Cartesian coordinate, cylindrical coordinate. So you know the formula. What is the value of rho? You know that Cartesian coordinates are made by x, y, z, any point represented in Cartesian, and any point represented in cylindrical is represented by rho, phi, and z, right? So you know the formula rho. What is the value of rho? It is x square plus y square. So how much will it be? It will be under root minus 2 square plus 6 square. So it is going to be under root 40, whose values is going to be 6.32. So this is the value of your rho. What is the value of phi? Phi is tan inverse y by x, which is equal to tan inverse 6 divided by minus 2. So we will have 180 minus tan inverse 6 by 2, which is equal to, you calculate it, 108.43 degrees. So now we got the value of phi, we got the value of rho, and obviously z is going to be the same. So z is going to be z is equal to 3. So we have all the three values, and this point P now represented in cylindrical coordinate as 6.32, 108.43 degree, 3. So this is how you will represent your point in cylindrical coordinates. Now, we have to convert this vector, which was in Cartesian, into cylindrical form. So from the previous formula, using this formula, we know the value of AX, AY, and AZ. We already know, right? What is AX? This is nothing but AX. AX value is 6, AY value is 1, and AZ value is 0. So we know all these three values, and we know the value of phi. So we just calculated, right, the value of phi and rho. So using this formula and using these values, we can directly calculate the values of A rho, A phi, and AZ. So what we will do, we will just put all these things in this formula, and we will get this thing. And if we put the values, we are going to get our A rho as minus 0.948 and A phi as minus 6.008. You just calculate it, right? All you have to do is you have to put all these values in this formula. So you know the value of phi, 108.43, so you can calculate cos phi. You already know the value of y and x and y, because this is nothing but ax, this is nothing but ay, and you already know the values, which is 6, 1, and then az value is 0. So you just put it in this formula and you will get this. So your final vector A will be, what is that vector? A rho plus A phi plus AZ. So if we put these values in this formula, we will get minus 0.948 A rho minus 6.008 A phi plus 0 AZ, because AZ component is 0. So this is how we converted point and the whole vector from Cartesian to cylindrical. And similarly, we can do the vice versa, opposite again. So I will ask you to do some examples from the book Sadiku, and it will become more clear to you. Thank you.